Inshallah, we today speak about, because we're gathering because of the Quran, we need also to speak about the Quran today. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He chose us. This is very important to put the Quran inside our heart, to understand the Quran, to reflect under the Quran. Because this is Allah chose who wants to put the Quran inside Him. And if I ask everyone here, who doesn't want happy in his life? I think all of you want. Yes? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Who doesn't want peace in his life? All of you want. Who doesn't want to be secure in his grave? All of us want. Who doesn't want to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by himself? Want to hear a Quran from him direct and tell him read and rise in the Jannah. Just imagine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by himself, He will ask you, I want to hear your voice. I want to hear my words by you. By your reading in front of me, you will raise a degree in the Jannah. Who don't want something like this? All of us want. Yes. Who doesn't want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Tell him, you are my family, you are belong to me. Who? I think the answer, all of us want this. If all of us want this, we must work for it. Because nothing is free. Even in our world, if we want something, we work for it. The problem, we want it, but we work in indirect way, or like we said, wrong way. We work for the world to collect the money, to we think that the money makes us happy, and we discover in the end, we don't feel happy, we don't feel peace. Even we don't spend our money, we collect it. Because of what? Because we give effort for something wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put inside everyone like a lamp. This lamp, if you want to turn on, it's not need electricity to work. It's not need to any charger to work. It needs just one thing, al-Rahman, to light inside you. Even we have Ibn al-Qayyim, is a famous alim. He just gave one word. And this word, really, if you act under it, or if you understand it and you practice, it will make your life easy. He said, person who begs for guidance with the Quran in front of him, he is as bad as the person who begged for the water and the cup of the water in front of him. Got it? This is a stupid person who begged for the water and the water in front of him. And we beg for the guidance and our guidance between our hands. Just see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you, like He said, give you jewelry. It's being different between us and the Sahaba. You see what the meaning of companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These people, they don't have a book like us. These people, they don't have a technology, a phone. I can hear a Quran in my work, in my car, in my street, in anything. These people suffering a lot. They travel to hear one ayah. And we have everything to hear the Quran Kareem, to have a connection with the Quran Kareem, and we never take it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask all of us for every single minute in your life. This minute, you waste it, or you use it for good deed, or you use it for bad deed? Which one? You have three ways. You're wasting your time, or you use it for good deed, or you use it for bad deed. The problem for us, maybe we don't use it for bad deed, but we're wasting a lot of our time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He described the Quran by Himself, I picked up one ayah in the Quran Kareem. This ayah, really, when I pick up, I feel this ayah touched my heart. That's why I chose this ayah. Because reciting the Quran Kareem is not just from here. Reciting from the Quran Kareem, it must come from here, from our hearts. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He by Himself tried to describe the Quran Kareem, what He said, Allah nazzala what? Ahsan al-hadith. Allah nazzala ahsan al-hadith. Let's translation this ayat and try to understand it by your heart, not by your mind. Allah by Himself revealed for you the best hadith in the world. Who said this? Allah. He gave it to you like a gift. How you use this gift? How you use it is very important. Allah nazzala ahsan al-hadith. What the meaning of ahsan al-hadith is? The best conversation. Yes? What does that mean, the best conversation? Every single letter is the best letter in the Quran Kareem. I don't tell you every word. I tell you every single letter is the best letter in the world. Every single word here is the best word in the world also. Every sentence, every order, every forbidden, everything is the best content for you. Did you feel it when you read it? I tell you this ayah because when you open the Quran, see the value. What is the value in your hands? What is the meaning? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by Himself tell you this is the best hadith in the world. Don't tell me the kitab hadith or kitab any book in the world, then in a sign and the Quran in another sign.